Now we will be doing the first problem. Now the BRS format is a very simple format. It is having a particular column and two amount columns. Now BRS, we say the heading as bank reconciliation statement, as on. If date is given, you enter the date what is given there. Now the first column we will take addition amounts to be added, and in the second column we will be taking the amounts that have to be subtracted. Now first, always you will be given balance of either cash book or passbook. So whichever book is given, that is your starting balance, and you have to find out the balance of the book which is not given. So always write down, suppose you are given cash book balance, you write this passbook as your target. This is how roughly you can write it in working notes, and be very sure whether the amount has to be added or subtracted. Using this simple format, you can write down, keep it initially with you while working out. Later you can do away with this, because everything you can do it mentally. Now let us take the first problem. Problem number one, passbook of a trader shows a balance of 12,600. Passbook of a trader, that means you are given passbook balance. So what you will be writing in particulars column, the first point is balance as per passbook. Balance as per passbook. We already discussed, if simply the word balance is used, and it is always a favorable balance. Whenever it is a favorable balance, always enter the amount in this plus column. Enter the amount in this plus column. So what is the amount of passbook balance given to you? 12,600. So I am entering 12,600 in the amount column. That is, be careful in the plus column. Whenever it is a favorable balance, just enter in the plus column. Now let us see the first statement A. It states that, okay, before that you are given passbook balance. So remember, you have to find out cash book balance. So this is your target. This is your target which you have to find out. Write down in a rough or a working note. Now statement A, checks deposited in bank but not collected. Now if you see both the formats, checks deposited is there in which cash book? After all, first you record it in cash book. Not collected means what? After you deposit the check, what the bank has to do? It has to take your check, it has to see the details, and it should consult the bank on which this check is drawn by the person who gave you the check. Find out from that bank whether that person is the same, whether he has money in his account, and whether he has given the check. After satisfying all this, it will request the bank to transfer the amount, and when that bank gives, finally it is said the check is collected and the amount is entered in the passbook. So he is telling clearly, check is deposited but not collected means naturally it ended here. So that means the entry is on the debit side of cash book. How much did you enter? 2100. So when you enter on the debit side of cash book, the cash book balance will increase. The cash book balance will increase. Now you are finding out cash book balance, it is increasing by 2100. So whenever it is increasing, we simply write plus against it. Means this amount should come into the plus column of your statement. So what would be the reason? Simply write whatever is given there. You can write whatever is given there. Write checks deposited. Checks deposited but not collected but not collected. Whatever is the statement there, you can write as it is. If you can write it in a shorter and a better way, you can shorten it. Now, the amount being 2100, we are adding. Why we are adding? I repeat, because it is check deposited. So the entry is in the cash book on the debit side. So whenever you are entering on the debit side of cash book, the balance will increase. Now, what is your target? Cash book. That is why you are checking whether cash book balance is increasing or not. It is increasing. Increasing means you write plus against it and write that amount in the plus column of your format. Now let us move on to the second one. Transaction B, checks issued but not presented for payment 1800. What is the meaning of check issued? You gave check to someone. Not presented for payment means what? That person did not go to your bank and take money by showing the check. So that means still the check is lying in his pocket or whatever. But first let us see what is the impact on our problem here. Checks issued is an entry in the cash book on the payment side. Now which book balance we are finding out? Cash book. Now let us see, when we enter something on the payment side of cash book, what will happen to cash book? The balance will decrease. So what you do is you put the arrow down indicating the balance should decrease, write 1800, and when arrow is down, put it as minus. So that means this 1800 should be entered into the minus column of the format. So what you will write? You will simply write the same statement. Checks issued but not presented for payment, the amount being 1800. Now next, CBIT, it states bank charges. Now refer your bank charges. Look, you will not find it in the cash book. You will find bank charges in your passbook. That is, they are service charges or collection charges. So now we have to enter this amount 175 in the passbook. Now in the passbook we have entered 175. So what will happen to passbook balance? It will come down. So we are talking about cash book. Passbook will come down, but we have to think about opposite for cash book because we are finding out cash book. So if passbook is coming down, we will say cash book is going up. By how much? 175. So when the balance is going up in the cash book or increasing, we have to add. So we have to write here, what is the bank charges. That means bank has taken some money from you and you did not enter in your cash book. As a result, your cash book balance is more by 175. Now let us take the transaction D. Bank paid insurance premium. Insurance premium is actually your expense. Your expense the bank is paying from your money which is there in the bank. So what will happen? It is a direct payment. So what is, how much is the amount? Direct payment 1500. So what will happen to your bank balance as per passbook? It has to come down, because whenever a payment is made by the bank balance has to come down. But what about the cash book? Because it's a passbook entry, we should think about opposite for this. So here, because of 1500 entry on the payment side, passbook balance is coming down, but cash book balance will increase. How much? 1500. So again you will add. So D you will write, insurance premium paid by the insurance premium paid by the bank rupees 1500. Now, next. Next we have, that is the last one, the debtor, that is EBIT. The debtor paid directly into bank account 200. Debtor is no one but your customer. So what is this customer of yours doing? He is putting money directly into your account in the bank. So into the bank, into the account means passbook. See on the this we have direct deposit. So it is a direct deposit by customer. How much? 1200. So what is the passbook format for here telling? Whenever amount is entered on the credit side, the passbook balance will increase. So our target is cash book. So when passbook balance increases, we say cash book balance decreases. It decreases by how much? 1200. So minus. So EBIT, you will say direct deposit, direct deposit by customer, direct deposit by customer. How much is the amount? 1200. We concluded it has to be deducted. This way you have entered all the amounts that are mentioned as the reasons for difference in cash book and passbook balance. Now how to close this? It is very easy to close. Just individually total both the columns. So here the total of minus column comes to 3000. Similarly, let us total this column 12, 14, 15, 15, 16, 2, 16,375. Now from this, this is just like ledger balance. Now from put the total which is more on both the sides.